Very we nice. Are doing Patty's Fix today, and yes. As everyone knows, this is my favorite segment. I'm really excited today, though, because I'm combining my two loves, you obviously, and my son's love for Spider-Man.
And you were telling me earlier, I want you to mention this. How old is your son now?
He's four.
Four.
But the obsession is real.
Okay.
I usually let him watch Spidey and Amazing Friends, which is age appropriate for him, and
okay.
I appreciate it. But
yes.
He also has watched the cartoon version, the first one, right?
This is 2018.
Yes, it has the Spider-Man or the Sunflower song, and that's his favorite song.
So I
let him watch it, but it was kind of a parenting decision for me because I was like, it's PG.
Yes.
I'm like, it's a little bit violent in some areas.
Is this a good choice? Even though it's animated, so your point is
I wish, because it's 2023, like, can't we give options to people? I wish they would do a G version,
you know,
take out some of the scarier scenes.
Yeah.
So, because it's a superhero and kids love it.
Yeah.
But I'm still probably going to let them see this because I'm tired of watching.
Now.
I'm tired of watching the first one. I'm ready for a sequel.
And you like it. So there's a review right there. This movie is part of a franchise that is doing exceedingly well. This is the sequel, as we mentioned, to the 2018 film. And yes, there will be another one.
What?
In just 9 months. In this film, our computer animated superhero, Miles Morales, aka Spider-Man, goes on an adventure with Spider-Woman across the multiverse, where he meets a new team of spider people known as Spider Society. You get the drift here. But comes into conflict with them over handling a new threat. Lots of great animation. We've got to give you that. That's my job to tell you that it is great animation. Visuals impelling. Oh, my gosh. And fans are already raving about it in advanced screenings. Rated PG runs 1 hour 57 minutes. Marvel Comics is counting their cash, so here you go.
When? Spider-Man, there's an elite crew with all the best spider people in it?
Who's the new guy?
This is unbelievable.
This is the lobby.
Miguel O'Hara.
The whole thing was his idea.
What's a guy gotta do to join this spider team?
You can never be part of this.
Don't even get me started on Doctor Strange and the little nerd back on Earth 1999-99.
Come on, go easy on the kid. He had a terrible teacher.
Peter.
Miles.
Mayday.
You have a baby?
I have a baby.
I'll take it from here.
All right.
Yeah.
That looks good.
Yeah.
I'm excited for the new one. It's funny, I saw a meme recently that said, Hollywood, you feeling okay? You haven't made a Spider-Man in 2 minutes. Because it does seem like they've made so many different versions of Spider-Man. But it's always a hit.
Yeah.
People love it.
And there's another one, as I said, coming out in 9 months. So that's good. You be aware, as Kayla said, rated PG. Parents have to make the decision. But it's out there. It already got like a 95% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Yeah.
So it's going
to... Don't judge me.
Oh, it's going to explode. Come up next, a film that was supposed to go to Hulu streaming, but test audiences liked it so much. Where's my coffee? that it will open exclusively in theaters. Also, Stephen King, who wrote the short story, saw the film and demanded it go to theaters. Mr. King generally gets his way. The movie is entitled Boogeyman. And yes, scary is the word. Two young girls, a teenager and her little sis, are in despair over the death of their mother. Their father doesn't seem to know how to give them the attention or the comfort that they need. Oddly enough, he's a therapist. And one of his clients shows up at their house unexpectedly and brings with him a nasty entity, a boogeyman.
No such thing as monsters. You need to grow up. I'm serious, Sawyer. I need to be alone.
Whoa, there you go.
Yeah, my son will not be seeing that one.
No.
And neither will I.
I'm still recovering. Rated PG-13 runs 1 hour and 38 minutes. Yes, this is some scary stuff. You notice I said stuff, right? It scared the stuff right out of me. I'm going to give it 4 out of 5 stars.
What? That high?
Well, he got what Stephen King envisioned. That's director Rob Savage. Did a lot with a little. And yes, again, this movie is almost entirely shot in the dark. But everything's scary in the dark. Boo! So it's just beware. It's pretty darn scary.
A
lot of this was shot, too. I was reading about it during COVID. So they couldn't do things in person. They were doing a lot of, by Zooming and everything. And to make that work, Rob Savage deserves credit for that.
Well, I will appreciate the talent from afar. Those are not my cup of tea. Today's question of the day, though, is brought to you by Kitchen Saver Custom Cabinet Renewal. The question, what's one movie everyone should see at least once in their lifetime? This is a good question for you, Patty.
Mary Poppins!
George says Mary Poppins. Mm-hmm. Rita says The Sound of Music. It has humor, drama, great acting, a compelling storyline, and memorable songs. I completely agree. I love The Sound of Music. Can you read this next one?
I can't see it.
Kathy
says, Gone with the Wind, yes. Of course. Now realize there are some people who are criticizing it now because they say, but that was the time and the place. So it represents the time.
And Susie says, the obvious one, Hoosiers. That is such a good movie. If you live in Indiana and you haven't seen that movie, go change that right now.
Another one, Shawshank Redemption.
Ooh, that is a good one. I'm not even into movies like that, but makes you into movies like that.
I want actors, I want storyline, I want script, and I want a good director.
And there you have it with Shawshank.